fall in love with the rum, you must fall in love with its country. In our first trip of Uncharted Territories, we discover Cambodia, Kingdom of Wonder, exploring its rare rums with our rare minds, the members of Rare Spirit Society. You are embarking with us on a 10-day adventure around the ancient mysteries of Siem Reap, to Phnom Penh's dynamic streets, the lush pepper farms of Kampot, to the idyllic waterfalls and beaches of Koh Rong Island.
We are about to do something amazing. We're taking a barrel of rare rum from Samai, and we're gonna hide it somewhere in the jungle.
But to film this documentary, we first need a filming permit from the Apsara National Authority.
Permiso, cabrón.
And during this expedition, we transport our four rare rum barrels of Cambodian rum to unique aging environments, embracing this land's diverse climates. So we are here in Siem Reap, in the temples of Angkor, one of the oldest civilizations in the world. The biggest Hindu temple in the world that was built 1,000 years ago.
It was lost for a long period of time and then rediscovered in the 1800s. And the idea we're here is because we have the exploration spirit, right? Like we're looking for the best place to age our rare rum barrels, the one that we have from Cambodia. And so that's what we're doing here. Let's explore, let's go inside, let's go back in time. Let's do this, let's find this place. Where do we put the barrel? Let's go. So we're arriving here at the Bayon Temple. After Angkor Wat, we spent a couple hours in Angkor Wat. Now we're at the Bayon, which is a blend of Hindu and Buddhist temple, which was actually designed in a way to convert people from Hindu to Buddhist. And you will see, there's 54 towers, and each tower has four smiling faces, the Buddha smiling faces. So that means there's 216 faces with the smiling Buddha. So let's try to find some and see how they smile back. Here we have Juan Carlos. The Rockets. Let's continue the journey.
Hello guys, my name is San, and my English speaking tour guide in Siem Reap. And today I'm so proud and so happy, which I serve my big team who are from Spain. And all are gentle and handsome guys. Also with those beautiful ladies, give me a big smile.
Siem Reap tour, khom bat chmua
Rare Spirit Society, hello. 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 And we even brought a barrel.
Welcome to Uncharted Territories, Cambodia Kingdom of Wonder 2023. This is our first trip of Rare Spirit Society, and we're very excited. The reason we're here is because we're looking for the best rums in the world. We're looking for rare rum barrels, which is part of what this society is. So that's the beauty of this project. We're here in Cambodia looking for those rare rums, and especially Samai Distillery, which is based here. And the idea of these 10 days is to learn about the culture, learn about rum production, why Samai Distillery is in Cambodia, why we are here. That's going to be also part of the journey. And but of course, the most important part is that we all have fun and that we enjoy the process, because there's no other point. A bunch of friends, a bunch of rare spirits, because I can see in your eyes, there's like definitely, you're all rare spirits.
Just be thankful for this opportunity that life is giving us to travel all around the world looking for rare rums and looking for ourselves as well.
We're gonna look for Diet, the GM of this hotel. Actually, I see her there. She's coming.
Now at Pulland Elephant Forest, we're stepping into a sanctuary of majestic serenity and wildlife conservation.
Tell us a little bit, like, how did this dream to create this amazing space, and how was the idea born, and why are you doing this?
In the 90s, my parents had the cultural project of bringing elephants back to the temples. And so they did in 2017. I had finished my studies. I came home for a sabbatical. And I spoke with my father, and I was like, maybe we should try it again this time. And he told me, okay. And I took over the 14 elephants at the time. And in December 2019, we opened Kulen Elephant Forest.
So this technique helps from what?
The sun and the bugs.
We should do the same.
Which is a project with the primary objective of ensuring a happy and healthy retirement to the previous riding elephants in Angkor.
I see.
There we go. Something like that. And you get going too.
And what is the elephant's favorite food?
They eat a lot of stuff, but they eat a lot of sugar cane as well.
Yes. Yeah. We make rum with this, but we also feed the elephants. We're traveling Cambodia, right? At the moment, we're here in Siem Reap. We're going back to Phnom Penh tomorrow. Kampot, Koh Rong, but we came to Siem Reap with a barrel, right? We have been today exploring all of Siem Reap. We went to Angkor Wat, we went to Bayon, we went to a bunch of locations actually looking for the perfect place to bring our rare rum barrel of Cambodian rum and find the best place that we believe has the good energy and the good atmosphere to actually age that barrel for a few years. And I believe we already found a place, and I believe we already know where it's gonna be, and we would love it to be here at the Kulen Elephant Forest. Well, we're gonna leave it here, and in 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, we're gonna come back and see what happens.
Yeah, I'm glad to find out what it tastes like.
Let's do it.
Perfect.
Do
it.
We seal our first Cambodian barrel, an ex-bourbon harboring a Samai rum blend of 80% column, 20% pot still at 55% alcohol. After going back in time in Siem Reap, we now head south 300 kilometers to Phnom Penh, the capital of Cambodia, a vibrant city.
Haran. So we're gonna get some haircuts because we need to look beautiful. And I think the best barbers of Phnom Penh are in this street. So let's get Kyle shaven in the head. Un cigarrillo. Mientras afeitan. Sí, sí, sí. Just relax.
There are four rules to Cambodia. One, always wear a condom.
Always.
Two, try any rum at least once. Three, have a cigarette while you get your hair cut. And four, shoulders back.
That's correct.
Want us to go there?
How guapo.
I'm gonna be the traffic guy.
Cambodia, there's sugarcane fields left and right, and fresh sugarcane juice in every corner. How come there was no local rum? That's how Samai Distillery pioneered its journey.
Like they go like with their hands like this, and they turn, and it can be any song, and they do the same dance that they're doing, you know? Let's go towards the food area, so we can try something to eat.
Fried rice with me.
Fried rice, thank you.
Yeah, I'm gonna wrap, eh? Beep. It's okay. Bueno, Salucita. Cambodia beer. Right now we're at Samai Distillery and we're here to pick up one of our barrels. So what we're doing today is we're gonna actually take this one to Wat Than, a temple, where we're gonna bless our barrel with the Buddhist monks. Okay, vamos. So how do you feel about going to bless our barrel in the Wat Than Temple?
I feel very blessed.
Already,
yeah.
The ceremony is at 10 a.m., so they ask us to be here at 9:30, half an hour before, because it starts at 10 a.m. sharp, and we're here, but we don't see the monks here. So I ask around, and apparently there's 300 different monks. So they're asking me, which monk is it? And I have no idea. We're being received in the main, the capo monk, the head monk of the whole pagoda. So we are actually in his house right now. Do you think this will be the first blessed Buddhist blessed barrel in the world, or
must be?
Our second barrel, an ex-bourbon filled with a blend of 80% column and 20% pot still of Samai rums at 55% alcohol.
So the First Priest Society members just arrived to Samai Distillery right now, and let's open the door and get them inside. Bueno, guys, we are right now at Samai Distillery, finally, you know, after you guys coming from all over the world. We have Taiwan, Madrid, Barcelona, Venezuela, Kuala Lumpur, Canada, Battambang, and Austin, Texas. We have here Daniel Pacheco. We're the two co-founders of Samai Distillery. And we're just like a couple of crazy guys, you know, in 2013, riding motorcycles naked through the sugarcane fields. That's how he imagines us.
That's what he came to do.
We're gonna become rum experts because we're gonna learn everything from the story, but also about fermentation, distillation, aging. We're gonna do a tour. We're gonna see things happening for real. Then we're gonna do a tasting of Samai products.
The first way we're gonna look at it is with the eyes, then with the nose, and then we'll end up with the mouth.
When I heard about Samai, they said, oh, Samai making rum. Rum is produced from the sugarcane juice. And I tried that. What is it? I never heard about rum before.
And now we have Cambodia's first master distiller and only master rum distiller in Cambodia, Madame Champik.
Hey guys, so we're gonna go on a little tour of the distillery where we're actually gonna see the whole production process. There's three main steps in the process. We have fermentation.
It starts getting warmer. Touch this one. Because that's the yeast working inside, converting sugar into alcohol.
Distillation. We take that beer, that mash that we produced, and we pump it into our two pot stills. As you can see, very, very traditional, handmade copper pot stills all the way from Portugal. So now what we wanna do is separate all of that mix of liquids to extract only what we want to keep to make rum and aging.
We're in the aging warehouse. So here we have around 300 barrels. So when you see a warehouse like this full of barrels, let's assume that they're all the same barrels, ex-bourbon, with the same liquid, filled the same day. After 2, 3, 4 years, when you taste each barrel separately, they're completely different animals, you know, like, because each barrel has their own personality. Antoine, explain us a little bit, what is that process of recharring and why do we need to do it?
So, because the barrel has been used one time in Kentucky to make whiskey, some of the wood components have been extracted already. So what we want to do now is to burn the layer of the wood that is used so that the rum that we're gonna pour in will access some fresh wood. So that's the main goal of this. And we'll also create a new layer of charcoal which will smooth the rum.
Let's light it on. Let's burn it, let's char it, let's toast it. Wait, let me put my wild because the sun is like intense. Whoa! Now we're coming actually to one of the most important parts, not only about today and the experience, but also about the whole trip of Uncharted Territories to Cambodia, because what we are going to do right now is we're actually gonna be tasting 5 different barrels. We're actually deciding today which barrel we're going to buy for the collection of Rare Spirits Society.
Let's make it official then. Today, the 3rd ever barrel of Rare Spirit Society has been chosen by the members who came to Cambodia in this first trip. Is the barrel sample 225-0042, which is a French oak, 100% pot still rum at 53.72% alcohol, aged for 6 years and 8 months.
So guys, it's a 225-liter barrel. And also, as an extra kind of plus for each of you as well, each of you can also choose one bottle that we're gonna bottle straight away. You are gonna label your own bottle, and this bottle is actually one of one. That means that nobody else in the world has that bottle.
We continue into the world of Cambodian craftsmanship, visiting local artisans such as Ambo Espadrille and D. Wilkins, where tradition meets artistry.
¿Cómo se llama esta callecita?
Esto es Massac Lane, de la parte de atrás.
Massac Lane for Detroit.
Sí, este es mi barrio, mi barrio. Esto es una pagoda, esto no entra en una pagoda.
Me llamo Ruby.
Tata. It's their first time in Cambodia.
Really?
And actually, they had never heard about Ambo Espadrille
really?
Before. So can you give us like a quick intro of what is Ambo, the idea behind
okay.
this?
Okay, so Ambo is like a shop where we have a workshop in there. We handmade in Cambodia, basically. And all of these are local products.
Tata. You want to bailar, Ambo?
It has been open since 9 years ago.
And that's when we started thinking like, okay, there's a lot of sugarcane in Cambodia.
It is the rum.
And there's no rum, right?
Like,
Cambodia needs a rum, right?
My name is Diego, and I will bring you to my workshop, please. My place of creation. Please, welcome. And this is my dog, Julio.
Oh, wow, tío, espectacular. Pero es muy especial venir a los talleres de los artistas, gente.
What we are going to do is to dress the neck of the bottle.
It's given a feeling of handcraft, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, it's not only the inside, you dress the lady outside as well. Red Society logo, and it will be a run, and then it will be stitch on the back, like cross stitch.
Championship.
Well, bro, if you want to suck it, you can suck it. And, bro, if you don't find the hole in the needle, then you have some issues.
I have issues.
Suave, suavecito, suavecito. Tienes que aplastarlo. You have to like flat down the edge. Okay. Do again. Same hole.
Like your shoelace.
No? And the other one. Hace lo mismo. Entra. Aquí. In the first one, yes. So there you start to close it, okay? No tiene que ser perfecto, tiene que ser auténtico. Oh, very good, good work. What is your bottom? No, 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 it's
solar.
Ah, solar is...
Mira, un beso aquí.
Un beso aquí. Respire. A esto es el te cortaste, te pinchaste.
Sí, sí,
Quiero una curita.
After immersing in the vibrant life of Phnom Penh, we journey 200 kilometers south to Kep, the coastal gem of Kampot province, celebrated as the capital of crab and the world-famous Kampot pepper.
So after spending time in Siem Reap and Phnom Penh, we're finally in one of my favorite, place in Cambodia, which is Kampot province. And right now we're in Kep. Look, welcome to Kep, capital of the crab. And it's in Kampot province, where is where the best pepper in the world is produced. So, the beach, we have the forest, we have rivers, jungle, and we're gonna have lunch right now and we'll get some crab.
Yes.
Some Kampot pepper. Yo. Let's get some crab in the crab market.
Set up my camera. I need a table.
Hey, Rita, pase, Feli.
Hello, Saksabai. Mien beer, cold. Cold.
Cold, cold, really cold. A beer, cerveza.
For breakfast. We go inside. You guys ready? Hello.
Good breakfast.
Can I try? Wow, look, fried crab. Tiny crab. It's very small. Mmm. Tastes like shrimp. This is amazing.
That's fine.
Yeah, everyone.
Okay.
Wow, and you eat the whole crab. It's like, ooh. With the shell, with everything. Oh. This is a huge squid, no? Delicious, I guess. You like? You eat every day?
Yeah. My job is to fry the big one and cook fry the pepper every day.
Okay. Nice. What is this? Como una sardinita. Hello, Saksabai. This is a shrimp in chili. But that's like in chili, right? It's like very spicy. Oh, wow.
Nice glasses.
I don't like the really small ones. We had a back
one. Amidst the chaos of a sudden downpour, we find serenity and gratitude, savoring each bite, reminding us to cherish every moment, no matter the storm.
Yeah.
down with a sugarcane juice.
That's a bit.
Not quite rum yet, but put a little bit of rum in it. Perfection.
So we're here in Kampot at the moment at Samai Beach. You can hear the birds, the rain, the wind. This is Kampot for me, is what I call the idle mode. You just be, you're in the present, enjoy the moment. Just be. At La Plantation Campo Pepper Farm. We're gonna taste today the best freaking pepper in the world. Campo Pepper, let's go.
What is this?
It's a
for you.
For your size.
Go. Good, very good.
Yay! Ambassador of... Thank you so much. Good?
Can you give us like a little intro as to how the whole idea of La Plantation started with you and Guy?
We start to fall in love with Asia, and then in 2013 we decided to travel in Cambodia, and we arrived in Kampot. We were lucky because we came directly to Kampot, and then we had a shock. We fell in love with the country and the people. And we decided to start a project. We found this land. We decided this is a perfect place to grow pepper and to live. It's, you can see all the hills, the mountains, the sea, the lake, the countryside, rice field. It's, we love it.
I mean, it's beautiful, you know. That's the beauty of the Campo pepper, which is like, it's spicy. It starts very, very mild. It starts building up. Has like some sweet notes. Well, you guys are gonna do a cooking class because I've been here in Cambodia for 10 years, so I'm already a Khmer food master chef. So,
wow.
Good job!
Thank you guys.
So, I let you guys now
oh my God, great.
Learn all the techniques and all the flavors and all the ingredients. You guys are going to be learning and cooking while I'm gonna be just hanging around. And as mentioned, listen carefully because we are gonna eat, I'm gonna eat your food as well. So please, don't miss any steps, you know?
Just have to build this back.
From Kampot, and you? Kampot? Me from Venezuela.
After tantalizing our taste buds with the world's finest Kampot pepper, we set sail with one of our rare rum barrels from mainland Cambodia to the tropical paradise of Korong Island.
This barrel is contained Korong Island, aging, tropical aging, amazing white sand.
Korong
blue
Island.
Waters.
Championship.
Let's see what
blue
happens.
Blue water.
And all this was possible thanks to Sir Byron the Goat.
Sir Byron the Goat.
Our leader, our main explorer.
Namaste.
He's taking us all over the world looking for the best drums. Byron the Goat.
On our first stop on the island, we go deep into the jungle, into the heart of Khor Rong's untouched wilderness, guided by my friend Jebe from C4 Adventures.
It's by a trail, which means like the lake of mangoes, the mango lake. And there is no mangoes and there is no lake. So here it's very rare. It's a bottled water tree. So this is how your bottles come to your supermarket. It grows on this kind of tree. It's very unique. The access to light is crucial. Without light, you die. We are in the north of Khor Rong right now. So we are in deep jungle, in primary jungle. And we are very lucky today because it's been raining this morning. We had a very big storm this morning. So actually our river is full of fresh water. My name is Jean-Benoît Lasselin, super French name. I'm from the south of France. And I arrived in Cambodia 15 years ago. And when I arrived here, I discovered many things, but just like you, Antonio, we see so much potential and we decide that let's turn our passion into a business. Let's share Cambodia. Let's make people discover what is the real Cambodia. So like you, I believe that this country has so much to offer to the world.
In this waterfall, you can feel how all our members, you know, from Rescue Society, everybody is like, you know, hugging each other and like contemplating, you know, like just sitting, absorbing this energy, which is amazing. Look, I'm even getting chills when I'm talking about this, because I mean, this is not something that you do every day, right? And like you're saying, you know, being in the city and so hectic. You know, we have members coming from Texas, from Madrid, from Barcelona, from UK, from Kuala Lumpur.
For those who want, we can push a little bit in the jungle and go to the upper level.
Having this opportunity to be in this spot, which you chose us, thank you, chose this spot, thank you very much. Like, it's amazing, man.
It's very important to step away from civilization to like our urban comfort and to come here. It's simple things. You just sit down, enjoy the waterfall, and just connect with people around you. This is what we are made for. We are not made for working all day long. We are made also to connect.
Well, this is work for some of us, but
it's, yeah.
But it doesn't feel like it, right? It's like...
And now let's go back to the beach, to the white sands and the blue waters.
It's around 6 a.m. at the moment. We just experienced the sunrise here in the island of Khor Rong. What a perfect closure to these 10 days of Uncharted Territories with all our members of Rare Space Society in Cambodia, because we have already experienced such different scenery, such different landscapes that Cambodia offers, you know? And it's also one of the locations that we chose to leave one of our rare rum barrels aging for a few years. So we brought an ex-bourbon barrel, a blend from Samai Distillery, which is 80% column still and 20% pot still at 55% alcohol. And we're gonna leave this barrel, it's gonna stay here in Khor Rong Island for a few years, aging in this weather.
But we are also acquiring from El Salvador, Puerto Rico, Mexico, Brazil. We're talking to distilleries in Hawaii, Venezuela, Guadeloupe, Jamaica, Philippines, and all these barrels are part of the Rare Spirit Society Rare Rum Collection.
How are you, my friend? So I would say Rare Spirit Society is a combination of work and pleasure.
Thank you, my friend. Championships.
So we found it. It's in my barrel. I think I'm gonna pour myself some on the rocks, because we just want to travel the world, try any rum at least once. So that's why we're here. We're gonna make rum the most amazing drink It already is the most amazing drink out there, but we're gonna make you see it and drink it. Salud. Sir Byron is the goat. He can climb any mountain. And guided by him, rare spirits will get out there. We will go where no one else has. In search of the most unique barrels of rum, rare spirits will travel the world, no looking back. We will uncover every continent, every corner, and every crack. We will try any rum at least once. Rare spirits would set out to acquire the gems, but we won't follow maps other men have made. We will follow our own big, hairy, audacious goal all around the world, living the dream from sugarcane to liquid gold. Rare spirits will explore uncharted territories and then share those stories with a drink in hand. We will own the finest collection of rare rums and rare minds. We know this journey will change us and we'll drink to that. So pack your bags, we're leaving. Show us back. Salud.